What's up, guys? I recently bought this beautiful UTG L96 sniper rifle, and today I'm going to show you my process for giving it that homemade look. If you saw my most recent Tippmann M4 video, you'd know I really like to customize my guns. I purposely bought a fully upgraded sniper rifle through the app HopUp. If you don't know about HopUp, HopUp is a fantastic app on your mobile device designated to buying, selling, and trading airsoft equipment. My younger brother introduced me to it last year, and I've been a premium member ever since. Now, like I said before, I did not want to have to open this thing up or really do any major internal upgrades myself. I primarily play the rifleman role, and I just wanted a pre-built, top-notch sniper to add to the armory. The internals of this thing are fully kitted out. The only internal work I may end up installing down the road is an S-Hop. But for now, you can find all the current internal upgrade parts in the description below. This video is going to focus on the externals of the rifle, both customizing it for functionality as well as giving it some visual flair. The main customizations I'm performing in this video are creating a custom rifle stock pouch, small and compact for one mag. This is a big deal because when you're using precision Navrich BBs, you don't want any dirt or anything getting into your mags, so having a pouch that you can zip completely shut is pretty useful. I'm going to add cushion and flare to the adjustable cheek riser. I'm going to add cushion and flare to the butt plate as well. I'm going to strip off and sand the bolt handle, returning it to a beautiful polished steel look. I'm going to create a custom suppressor with foam to hopefully absorb the sound and vibrations when the rifle shoots. I'm going to add a low profile sight riser for implementing my shot cam, and I'm going to add some visual flare to the rifle with tan camo tape and brown electrical tape. As you can tell, the rifle has already been painted, which I actually really like, so I'm going to make sure that all of my customizations fall within that pre-existing color scheme. First things first, I'm going to disassemble the rifle and give the bolt assembly a nice cleaning. Then it's time to start applying the liquid paint stripper to the handle. I've taped off the surrounding areas so no splashes remove any of the paint that I want to stay. I let it sit for about 15 minutes and then rinse and dry, followed by a smooth sanding. I then add two strips of electrical tape at the base and the end of the bolt shaft for some contrast. Moving on to the adjustable cheek rest. I mark the area where I like the cheek rest to be and I remove it to apply the cushion. For the cushion, I'm using a packing foam. I work with a foam company in my day job, so you're going to see a few types of foam used in this video. However, they are just samples I got from the studio, so I cannot provide any info on what types of foam they are. I use some electrical tape to get the foam roughly in the right position, and then I cover it with two layers of cloth camo tape. I'm adding one more ring of electrical tape to the base, giving it a nice clean look. Although I only show it here, I always use super glue on the ends of my electrical tape wraps for a permanent seal to the layer below it, making it stay on until you want it off. To save some time, I did not show it, but for the buttstock, I repeated the same process, but with two layers of foam instead. Next up is giving the handle some grip as well as some color. Nothing crazy here, just a clean camo tape wrap with the ends being sealed off with brown electrical tape. I was really happy with how this next part turns out. For my custom-made rifle stock pouch, I'm using a small khaki sunglasses case and two strips of khaki Velcro. I simply removed all the unwanted straps from the back of the sunglasses case because they're oriented the wrong way, and I made four slits into the back of the pouch. Two vertical sets for the Velcro to enter and exit through. I then burned and melted the incisions so that they would be less likely to tear, and then I fed the Velcro through. Once the Velcro was through, I just pulled tightly and cut off the excess. And that's it. When it came to the scope, I just wanted to add some visual flair. A few rings of camo tape and electrical tape gave me the look I wanted. For the final big piece of this project, I wanted to add the look of a suppressor without actually extending the barrel at all. So I decided I was going to add a layer of foam to my outer barrel in hopes to reduce the vibration and sound, but mostly for aesthetics. I wrapped an adhesive foam pad to the barrel and tied it tightly around with electrical tape. Once again, to give it that clean look, I'm actually going to slide an old tracer unit shell over the foam to keep it tight. The shell fit like a charm, so I took it over to the paint bench to give it a khaki makeover. To clean up the exposed end of the suppressor, I made a ring of brown electrical tape over a ring of Velcro for a solid, movable end cap. I also added a few features off camera, such as a padded handrest near the magwell, as well as a layer of electrical tape on the outer barrel to help it sit more tightly in the bottom receiver. Now it's time to assemble the rifle and see how she looks. Thanks for checking out the video, guys. I hope you enjoyed my homemade slash post-apocalyptic customization video. I enjoy giving all my guns a personal touch, and I really liked how this one turned out. I actually plan on using this rifle in some games tomorrow, so make sure to subscribe to my channel to be notified when that video goes live. Until next time, guys, I'll see you on the field.